Mr. Excel podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Mark Excel from Mr. Excel podcast, episode 1273, Save a Form. Well, hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel netcast. I'm Bill John. Today's question, sent in by Kim. Kim's been watching the podcast and says that she wants to have a way to take data from a form. She might give this to a customer or something like that, and copy that data and paste it into the next spot on sort of like a database kind of thing. And she says, you know, hey, look, I don't want to get in and code a lot of VBA. Can you do this somehow without making me code any VBA? She tried to record a macro that would copy and paste transpose. However, couldn't figure out how to get it in the next row. So we're going to use the macro recorder here. I'm just going to select a cell before I start. Go to record macro. Let's call this post to database. Control Shift S for save. Click OK. All right, so now the macro recorder is running, and most of the time I tell people that they need to go in and turn on relative reference, but I don't want to do that here in this case because the first part of this macro is going to be absolute. Every time we run the macro, we want to come here to the form worksheet and select those four cells every single time. I don't care where I started, where the cursor was to begin with, I always want to select those cells. I'm going to copy. I can use Control C, or I can go back here on the Home tab and choose Copy. All right, then we're going to go to Database. And again, this next step is also going to be absolute, not relative. I'm going to use Control G or F5 for Go To. I'm going to go to the last cell in the spreadsheet. So A1048576. By the way, A, B, C, you should choose a column that is always going to be filled in. So if one of these is optional, don't choose that column. Choose another column. Click OK. That sends us down to the bottom. Now at this point, we're going to change the macro recorder into relative mode. Relative mode. So we go back to View, Macros, use Relative References. And from here, I'm going to press Control Up Arrow. Control Up Arrow will get me to the point where I'm on the last row of data. Because Relative is turned on, I now press Down one more time. And we can go to Home, Paste, and transpose. There it is right there. And it pasted. We're now good to go. At this point, I want to get out of relative mode and go back into regular mode. So I go back to View, Macros, turn off relative reference, go back to form, probably clear the data. I'm not sure if Kim wants to do that or not. Let's assume we want to clear the data. So we'll reselect the data, press delete, and then select the one cell. So that way the person is ready to start filling out the form. All right, so we stop recording. All right, now it's Control Shift S if you're a keyboard person. If you're not a keyboard person, let's just create an easy way to save this form. I'll come back here. We could either do clip art or we could do shapes. I'll just choose something, the lightning bolt. Put a little lightning bolt there. Oh, that's a horrible color. Let's just go with plain and right click, assign macro, and that's the macro we just recorded. Click OK. All right, so now PO number, fill that in. Department is manufacturing. Contact name is Joe. And the contact number 555-1212. Click the lightning bolt. Bam. And you saw the screen flash there a little bit because we didn't get into VBA. We couldn't turn off screen updating. But when we go look, you'll see that it is now written to the next row. So it seems like a bit of a hassle having to go to the last row. Control up arrow to get to the last row with data and then down one, but it solves the problem. Did that whole thing with the macro recorder. Never had to go look at VBA. Well, hey, I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.